Oh, here goes.
I am the cheese! I am the best character on the show!
Taking all bets, guys! Taking all bets!
Here, I have had 50 gold doubloons on the short one!
You're into a world of hurt.
I call upon the hammer of godly lightning! I summon you!
Now that is irony!
Fucking asshole!
That's enough!
That woman's as cold as a nudist on an iceberg.
We'll be right back. You'd best avoid that place.
Why?
There's an elf woman who lives there, and she's a bit of a strange one.
It can't be. Mother is in this house? Who's there?
Stay back! I got gardening tools!
Excuse us. I have something I would like to ask you.
Oh, half-elves. My child is a half-elf, too.
It's a doll.
See? She has such an intelligent-looking face, doesn't she? Her name is Rain. She's my pride and joy.
Here's a fruitcake.
Huh? She has the same name as... It can't be.
Right now, I have another child on the way. I've already decided on a name. If it's a girl, it's Jean. If it's a boy, it's Genus. What do you think? Lovely names.
What? Then...
Are you Virginia?
Yes, that's right. How did you know?
Ah!
stop this.
Ah, here it goes!
Professor Sage.
Stop this! What were you thinking? Do you know what happened to the two of us since you abandoned us? What? Why are you raising your voice like that? You'll wake Rain! I'm Rain! I'm the daughter you shunned and abandoned, not that doll! Genus is here too! What are you talking about? There must be something wrong with you. You're the one that's wrong! How could you? How could you? Oh, you've gone and made Rain cry. Please leave. There, there. It's okay, Rain. The scary people have gone now.
Nice girl, but about as sharp as a sack of wet mice.
How could she? First she abandons her children, and then she abandons the memory of doing so. She doesn't even remember us.
Rain, don't cry.
So, you met Virginia.
Why is she here?
Several years ago, I found a husband and wife collapsed of exhaustion in the Ymir forest. It was Virginia and her husband, Kloitz.
Father.
It seems Kloitz was dispatched from Miltokio to investigate the elf village. He fell in love with Virginia and remained in Heimdall, but...
But a half-elf that lived in the village tried to sell out our father to the soldiers. It became a huge incident. Fighting broke out between the elves and half-elves.
The cause of the incident, Virginia's family was banished from the village. They traveled from land to land, but the world was not kind to half-elves.
And we were abandoned.
So it would seem. And Kloitz must have been ill. For he died soon after they arrived in this village. Virginia began to lose her mind from that day.
She's unbelievably selfish. She tosses us aside on a whim and then forgets us. And just goes off into her own little world of dreams.
Even so, Virginia was worried about you two. In the legendary land of Silverant, surely half-elves will be free from discrimination. I want them to be happy. That's what she said.
I've heard enough.
I've been keeping Virginia's diary safe here. You can come get it at any time if you ever decide you want it. Do you want to read the diary?
Professor, this is...
The otherworldly gate has opened. Rain, Genus, please forgive your powerless mother. Surely even the Imperial Research Academy will not follow you to Silverant. This must be a better choice than to spend your life in that damp, filthy dungeon like a slave. Please, make your way to freedom.
What did she mean?
Rain, you must have been incredibly talented. It seems the Imperial Research Academy was dying to get its hands on you.
That's why we couldn't settle down anywhere and had to keep traveling.
Eventually, you were chased all the way to the otherworldly gate. It seems she managed to send you through it.
Mother.
Then... she didn't abandon us because we were in the way, or that she hated us, or anything.
Yes, that's right.
Rain, this is great news!
This diary...
take it with you. It is your mother's, after all.
Thank you.
Fuck you! Hey, there's a whole lot of fucking going on in this room!